I'll pass you now, darling.
No, Mario, take yourself off to bed. You're all going to hear me in the morning.
Beep!
Thank you.
Here we go.
Well, it was late in the night and the sight of the light began to happen. When sleepy heads were in bed, dreaming dreams full of fantasy appeared. When frosty fingers were painted on the grass, and icy whispers were echoing around, and even as barely breathing with the sound, then something happened.
Thank you.
But my meal has just begun. when I smell the blood of an Englishman.
Thank you. Daxter lay gazing longingly upon the huge and golden tree. He murmured softly,
"Golly gosh! Golly gosh! Golly gosh! I like that word. Golly gosh! Come on, say it!
Golly gosh!
You all can do better than that. Say
it! Golly gosh!
Golly gosh! I guess I'll have to take a wash. If I'm going to climb up this tree without the giant smelling me, in fact, that's my only hope."
She rushed indoors and grabbed the soap.
Gently, gently.
Jack was nimble, Jack was keen. Once more she climbed a mighty beam.
No sooner had Jack scaled the beam, the giant entered, gross obscene. Muttering through his vicious teeth, while Jack sat tensely just beneath.
"Proof 5.